Hello and welcome to Etcetro. Today I'll be sharing with you a very useful tip for pivot table reporting with the help of Power Query. Suppose you are dealing with multi-currency reports and you want to create your pivot report showing various other currencies based on your home currency. As you can see on the screen, I have a multi-currency report where AUD is my home currency, which is Australian dollar, and I'm able to convert AUD to other currencies like Euro, GBP, New Zealand dollar and USD. The exchange rates are live exchange rates, which are full from website. It's called xc.com. We'll be using Power Query tool to set up the data source for this pivot table. If you have no idea what Power Query is, then I highly suggest you go through many free tutorials and articles available on internet. YouTube would be the best resource to start with. In short, it is the best data cleansing and transformation tool developed by Microsoft. It is part of Microsoft's Office BI and Intelligence products. I won't be going through into the basic on how to use Power Query, but I will walk you through the process of building the multi-currency database for our final report in the Power Query. And if you're really curious and a master Power Query, I highly recommend a book called M for Data Monkey, which is available for around $10 on Kindle or PDF version. Links for buying this book are in the description of this video. So let's get on with the process and I'll show you how to create this kind of report. So first step is to open your sample file. Here I have named it Sales Currency Data Demo. Power Query is not readily available as a tab in, as you can see on my screen. I'm using Excel 2010. So if you're using Excel 2010 and 2013, it is not part of your package. You have to download it from Microsoft website, which is free. And if you're using Excel 2016, it is under the Data tab in Get and Transform section. So I have downloaded Power Query already, and I will leave the links for downloading the same in the description as well. So once you download Power Query, it will appear as a tab. Now to start with, you have to link all the individual workbooks which are in Excel and which are for the different countries. The source data which we're going to use are in this folder called sales data, and these are the five countries data: Canada, France, Germany, Mexico and USA. Now we want to import all the files in Power Query as a single database. So is this all these files has individual sheets which we are interested in. I'll show you how to do that. So for that we need to go to Power Query. We go to File and Import from a folder. We're going to be pasting the folder path as I showed you before and click OK. The Power Query window will open. We need to go to Edit. And here is the folder details. There is file name, the version and other details which we are not interested. Only column is important is content column. So we're going to be selecting that and remove other columns. Now, if we're going to click this, we won't get the data because currently Power Query doesn't have capability to import all the records from Excel files as a source files. Suppose if you have CSV file, text file, you can do it directly. But since our source files are Excel files, we are going to use a custom column with a formula. So I'm going to adding a custom column and we're going to using a formula called excel.workbook. We're selecting the content column and click OK. Now the new column is added, named table, so we don't need this content column. And now we need to click on this button with double arrow like this and click expand. Now you can see all the sheets which we have imported has different tabs which you can see here. So whatever you are interested, we're going to be filtering that in custom name column. So let's select Canada, France, Germany, Mexico and US. Now the column we are interested is this custom data column, which is have a double headed arrow like this. So we're going to be selecting that and remove other columns. Now we're going to be expanding this column because this has all the data we need, and we're going to be clicking this double headed arrow. We're going to be loading it more and click OK. Now first thing we need to do is to promote this first row as a header. So let's use that. And since we had a lot of headers in five different files, same headers, we have to filter out the duplicate header details. So we're going to be going to this particular filter and going to be deselecting the date. So the headers will not be repeated further in the report. Now we need to transform the data. We need to change the types of data. So first column is date, so we're going to be converting this particular data as date, and then all these columns from segment, country, product are tax. So we're going to be converting it to tax, and these two columns are financial figures, so we're going to be converting it to decimal number. Now let's unpivot these two columns, because we need this column as an unpivoted format. So we're going to be selecting this column. As you can see, I have already selected them. Right click and unpivot columns. Now they are unpivoted. We're going to be naming this as a measure. Now our set is ready. Now we need to add more columns for other currencies, as I showed you before. So we're going to be adding four more currencies: New Zealand dollar, US dollar, euro, and GBP. Now to do that, first we need to create another query for those currencies as a live website database. So to do that, we're going to be going to home, we're going to be going to new, so other sources, web. So in exe.com you have to type AUD, which is our home currency sign of the dollar, and let's select AUD here. And now we got the AUD versus other currency figures here. We're going to be cleaning up the currencies which we don't need, and we'll be keeping the currency we want. So let's copy this particular URL and go to Power Query window and paste it here and click OK. Now we are not interested in this document table, we need interested in table 0. So let's click that and click OK. First step would be to name the query. I'll call it currency, and we're going to be cleaning up the data. So let's promote the first row as a header. Just ignore this 59 for a while. We're going to be removing that anyway. And the row we are interested is AUD versus other currencies. So we're going to be filter that. And now we got the AUD versus other currency rate. So we are not interested in other currencies like INR, Thai Baht, Malaysian, Singaporean, and BHD. So let's remove these columns and let's change the data type. So we're going to selecting this and go to transform and decimal number, and this is text. You can name this as well currency. Now this table is ready to be loaded. So we're not going to be converting a table, we're going to be loading it as a connection only. So let's go to home, close and load to only connection. Now you can see the two queries as connections: sales data and currency. So let's go to sales data. Now we're going to be merging this to currency and sales data table, but before we do that, let's bring in a common particular lookup column, because we're going to be merging queries and we need a common lookup column which will be temporary. So to do that, we'll go to add column, add custom column, and name is as a helper column, and the value would be 1 AUD. I'll tell you in a second why I put 1 AUD, and click OK. Now column has come, we're going to be converting it to text. Now reason why I have made this column 1 AUD, why? Because we need to look up this particular value against our currency table. So if I go to currency, I have same text here, 1 AUD. Against that, we're going to look up all these four columns. So this is a temporary column, we can remove it later on. So now let's merge these two queries. We'll go to home, merge queries, and we can be selecting currency. And which are the common columns here? Help column, 1 AUD, and currency. And click OK. So this will bring in a new column called table table. This has our data. So we're going to be expanding the same by clicking this double headed arrow. And whatever we want to bring in, we have to click that. So I don't want this currency. I want only the GBP, Euro, New Zealand, and USD. So as you can see, all the four columns are here. Properly data type is converted. And now we can remove this helper column. Now we are not still done yet, we need to multiply this particular exchange rate with our home currency. So we'll be creating four more columns: GBP, Euro, USD, and New Zealand. So to do that, go to add column, custom column. First column would be GBP. We're going to be multiplying it with our home currency to get the equivalent GBP values. Click OK. As you can see, 32,370 Australian dollars equal to 19,941 GBP. Similarly, we'll be creating a euro currency column multiplying with our home currency. So to do that, we're going to be going to custom column and name it euro AUD multiply by euro rate. Click OK. And we got the equivalent euro column for our home currency. Similar way for the two currencies. So custom column and CD. Let's multiply AUD with exchange rate of New Zealand dollar. Click OK. And the last column would be USD, which will be AUD, our home currency, versus exchange rate of US dollars. Now let's remove these four columns, which are the exchange rates. We don't need that. And rename this to euro. Now let's convert the data types. Transform to decimal number. Now we got equivalent value of other currencies compared to our home currency, which is AUD. So GBP, Euro, New Zealand and USD. So let's select all of this and unpivot them. And this attribute column should be named currency and this should be named amount. Right, so our data set is ready now to be loaded to Excel. So we'll go to home, close and load to. Since it was loaded as connection only, it won't show as table. So we can edit it immediately by right clicking this particular query and load to table, click OK. As you can see, 7,000 rows are loaded. We don't need to format this particular values because we'll be creating a pivot table out of it. So we don't need to do that. This is just a raw table, but it is completely flexible. It is connected to the web. So if I right click and refresh it, the query is running in the background to get the latest exchange rates for this currency values. So let's summarize this as with pivot table. So we're going to be clicking this particular button. You can quickly create a pivot table. And let's create on a new worksheet. We're going to be hiding our Power Query window. Let's put a country into row headers, product into row headers, measure into column headers, amount into values. So let me fast forward this particular section of the video where I'll be formatting this table according to the way I want. So just bear with me for a while. Now I have formatted my pivot table the way I want to look at. Now I'll show you the trick where you can put here a slicer to change the currency display. So currently it is showing all the currencies together. So this data is completely false. So we need to select a currency in which we want to see the data. So to do that, we go to go option and insert slicer. We're selecting currency, click OK. Let's modify this quickly. We have total 5 currencies and let's increase the width like this and let's remove the header of the slicer I don't want and shrink it a bit. Now if you click AUD, you'll see AUD. If you click Euro, you'll see Euro. If you click GBP, you'll see GBP values, New Zealand and USD. Now the beauty of this report is it's completely automated. Now next month, whenever you have more files for more country, you just have to go to the root folder and paste it there. Even if it is Excel file, just paste it there and your report will be updated automatically. And since the currency rates are refreshed every day, actually every hour and every minute, you can always do that. So to do that, to see the latest currency rate against our home currency, which is AUD here, you need to go to data and refresh all. The query will run in the background, we'll get the latest rates from the xc.com website, of course. So this is the method you can use to automate your reporting in multi-currency format whenever you have your home currency and you want to see comparative other currencies as well. And this is completely automated, as I said before. If you use Power Query, you just have to set it up once, and you can always generate these reports all the time with the latest action rate. So thank you very much for watching, and I hope you have enjoyed this tutorial, and please share it on your social media and other places where you think it will be useful for others. Also, I'll be coming up with a new course soon, a free course on Udemy. I already have a course called Mastered Appreciation Accounting with a pro Excel template, which is linked in the description below. You can enroll it for free. I have prepared a pro appreciation template using straight line method, which takes care of most of the practical scenarios. So once again, thank you for watching, and I'll see you in my next video.